The song was Working for the Weekend. The year was 1982. I'm Paul Dean from Loverboy, and these are the sounds of the time. Oh yeah, the 80s, the best 35 years of my life.
Paul Dean and Mike Reno formed Loverboy in Calgary in 1979 and gained popularity in the U.S. just as a new era of optimism and prosperity was beginning.
It was big hair, big hits, big ambient drums, and because we'd grown up in the 70s where everything was, especially with the Eagles, it was really tight and clean and dry and in your face, and the 80s started opening up and getting bombastic and big synths, massive bottom end everywhere.
Loverboy adopted a signature look to stand out among all the color and flash.
Somebody who worked at our office also owned a leather store. And she said, you guys want to come down? I'll give you I don't think it was free, but I'll give you 50 off or something, you know? So we went, yeah, let's go check it out. And there were these red leather pants. And we went, oh, this is good.
But it was a band sound that really captured the essence of the era.
It's a tough thing to explain the sound of Loverboy. I always think of it as a funky bass and a metal guitar and almost a military style drums, because that's where Matt came from. He played in the military band in school. That kind of thing. So Loving Every Minute of It has that, and War Bride on our previous album has that. And then we got the classically trained keyboard on top of that. And then we have a singer who sings blues style to pop melodies.
The dazzling range of styles and influences produced a string of top 10 hits for the band.
The first one was Turn Me Loose off the first album. And then we did Working for the Weekend and When It's Over and Gangs in the Street on our second album. And our third album had Hot Girls in Love and Queen of the Broken Hearts. I would say that Working for the Weekend has had the most success across the board. One day I was looking for song titles. I'm always looking for song titles, little phrases that catch me and stay with me. So I'm walking downtown or in my neighborhood in Vancouver, and it was a Wednesday, and Wednesday 11 o'clock in the morning or something, and I'm walking around and there's nobody there. Usually it's just teeming with people. I lived really close to the beach, and I walked on, where is everybody? God, what are they doing, waiting for the weekend? And I went, oh, Waiting for the Weekend. I like that. We were in rehearsal one time, and I'm playing it for Mike, and he's going, what if we called it Working for the Weekend? And so I went, yeah, I guess that would work. What did I know? I mean, what a brilliant idea. But at the time, it's like, yeah, I'm easy. When we were first learning the tune, we were still playing clubs. We hadn't headlined, and we were in between. I think we hadn't recorded it yet. And we were playing this meat market club in Nanaimo, British Columbia. And we played the first set, and everybody's just no dancing, no involvement with the band. They're just yakking to each other. They occasionally look over at the band or whatever, you know. And the second set, same thing. And the third set, we opened for Working for the Weekend, and the dance floor was packed right there. And I'm like, okay, this is probably going to do well. Everybody's working for the weekend. Dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun.
The song is one of the rare 80s classics that still regularly shows up on the airwaves today.
Well, I'm sure there's more than one station across the North America, maybe Europe as well, at 5 o'clock on Friday afternoon, you get that donk, donk, donk. It's just a party song. It's the essence of Loverboy. We are here to entertain you.